Okay, students, good morning to all of you. So we are discussing current electricity, and in that current electricity we have derived some derivations and some definitions also we have discussed. Yes, what is drift velocity and what is the formula for drift velocity? E capital E divided by small m into tau, relaxation time, and relation between current and drift velocity, I is equal to n small e capital A Vd. That relation also we have discussed. Okay, na? Yes. And after that, we discussed about mobility. Mobility is nothing but Vd by E, drift velocity acquired per unit strength of electric field. And what did they say? Unit we have discussed. And thereafter, we discussed about current density. Current density is nothing but J is equal to I by A. Okay, do you remember all this? And NEVD also, NEVD. Is equal to J. These are all points we have discussed in previous classes. Okay, now today we are going to discuss about Ohm's law. Yes, what is Ohm's law? Students, let us suppose, yes, you know this all, everything, but let us discuss one more time. Still any point is not clear for you, that will be clear from here onwards. Okay, yes, let us suppose this is even a current carrying conducting wire. Okay, yes. Now, so in this wire, what will be there? There are so many number of free electrons, valency electrons will be there in the structure of this metal. Okay, yes. Now, let us suppose this conducting wire, let us suppose we have connected to a battery which is having a potential difference of V volts. Let us suppose here V volts, here 0 volts, so V minus 0 is V volts. Okay, and this is connected to this, so whenever you connect this current carrying wire to the battery of having potential difference V, and let us suppose the length of this current carrying wire is, let us suppose, L, then what happened, Anna? Across this length of the wire, one electric field will set up in this direction. From higher potential to lower potential, an electric field will generate. Okay, clear? Yes. And due to this electric field on these electron, a force will act, and due to that force, these electron will accelerate towards a positive plate. Means these electrons are moving. Clear, students? Yes. So whenever these electrons move, we will this flow of electrons will get current. Means current is flowing in this direction. Means electrons are flowing in this direction. In the sense, this current is flowing from positive plate to negative plate. Like this, current is flowing. As the electrons are moving in this direction like this, current is flowing in this direction. Always conventional current is in opposite direction to the opposite direction to the flow of electrons. Electrons are flowing like this. Conventional current will flow in this direction. Okay, yes. Now, between potential difference which is applied across this length of the conductor and current flowing through the conductor, there is one relation is there. Yes. Now, under constant physical conditions. What are the physical condition? Imagine temperature remains constant. Temperature and mechanical strain. If these two are remains constant, the potential difference between two ends of the current carrying wire is directly proportional to amount of current flowing through the wire. This, by doing experiment, we have got this relation. This is the statement of Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that under constant physical condition like temperature and mechanical strain, the potential difference across two ends of this current carrying wire is directly proportional to amount of current flowing through this wire. Okay, now to remove this proportionality constraint, we should keep one constant term here, and that constant term is nothing but R. Here, R is nothing but resistance. Resistance of a wire. Okay, and this resistance R is can be written as V by I. Okay, na? So what is resistance? Already you know, resistance is nothing but oppositions to the yes, Abhay, correct. Okay, now the resistance of this current carrying wire is nothing but the opposition, means these electrons while they are flowing like this, what will happen? They will collide with the positive ions of this crystal lattice of this in this current carrying wire. They will collide with positive ions each and every time. While they are accelerating, they will collide with positive ions. Due to that, their motion is stopped. Okay, Anna? Are you getting? So that the opposition, good, inherent property to oppose the flow of electrons, that property we call it as resistance. Okay, it's very easy definition. And also it can be defined as, it is a ratio between potential difference across the length of the wire upon the amount of current flowing through the wire. Okay, and students, its SI unit is resistance. SI unit is volt per ampere, and it is also called as ohm. What we call ohm, and symbol for ohm is this, like this ohm symbol. Okay, SI unit of resistance is volt per ampere. Nana, you need to remember this. Okay, yes. Next one, yes, dimensions of resistance. What, Nana? Yes, you need to write dimensions. Dimensions of resistance, how to write? Write basic fundamental unit, that's it. Yes. Voltage, how can we write volt? Students, we know V is equal to W by Q. Do you know? Yes. W by Q is nothing but joule per coulomb. And joule per coulomb can be written as ampere into second. Voltage unit can be written as joule per ampere second. Okay, yes, I'm writing. Joule per ampere second divided by ampere. So joule per ampere square second. We know joule is nothing but kg meter square per second square upon ampere square second. So the basic unit will become kg meter square second power minus 3 ampere power minus 2. So dimensions will be m l square t power minus 3 a power minus 2. These are the dimensions of resistance. How to write? Just write basic fundamental unit for that quantity. You will get the answer. We know resistance unit is volt per ampere. Volt unit is nothing but potential difference. Potential difference is nothing but work done per unit charge. That is nothing but joule per coulomb. Joule per coulomb can be written as ampere second. Yes, right here. Joule per ampere second by ampere. Joule per ampere square second. Joule is nothing but kg meter square per second square. This is by ampere square. Okay. Yeah. So this one send you upside, you will get ampere power minus 2, second power minus 3. So write that units to their fundamental basis. M L square T power minus 3 A power minus 2. Yes, these are the dimensions of resistance. Yes. So if you remember, it will be benefit to you, or otherwise you should do like this, how I have done. Okay, yeah. Students, now resistance is the fundamental property of the material. Students, as this formula is there, R is nothing but V by I. R resistance does not depends upon depend on potential difference and current. Nana, it is just a mathematical formula, but it does not depend upon the value of potential difference and current. Purely resistance value depends upon nature of the material and dimensions of the material and direction of flow of current in that material. Okay, na? So this point it is very important, you need to remember. Okay, so they may ask you factors on which resistance of a wire or resistance depends. On what factors resistance depends, yes. R value depends upon, R value depends on, depends on first one, nana, nature of material. What type of material it is? Nature of material. Okay, means conductor, one type of resistance. Semiconductor, one type of resistance. Insulator, another type of resistance. For conductors, different conductors, silver, aluminium, copper, so many we are having, no? For different material, different R value will be there. Means it depends upon the nature of the material. Okay, and second one is dimensions of wire. What wire we are using, that wire dimensions what? Okay, means area and length. Okay, yes. And third one is this resistance depends upon direction of flow of current also, Rana. Direction of flow of current. Flow of current. In which direction current is flowing? In that, on that point also resistance depends upon. Okay, yeah. So you need to remember resistance depends upon nature of the material, dimensions of the wire, and direction of flow of current. Okay, students. Yes, question will arise: how resistance of a material or wire, how it depends upon dimensions of a wire and nature of the material. Students, you know resistance of the wire is directly proportional to length of the wire. Okay, more is the length of the wire. So this wire we have taken more. Let us suppose more length of the wire we have taken. Now what happened, Nana? Oppositions for the movement of the electron increases because many times this electron has to collide with positive ion. So its resistance, oppositions to the flow of electrons also increases. Now, and this resistance of a conducting wire is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Let us suppose we are having a small area of cross section of the wire and a large area of cross section of the wire. Then in this number of electrons, in this number of electrons, if you compare here, they can move very freely compared to this, means opposition get reduced. Okay, so that's why it is inversely proportional. Clear? Yes. Resistance, opposition, when you increase the area of cross section of the wire, resistance of the wire means opposition to the flow of current will decrease. So that's why resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Now, by combining these two, you can write R is proportional to something L divided by A. Now, to remove this proportionality constraint, we should keep one fixed value that is called as rho. Okay, rho into L by A. Here, rho is called as resistivity. What we call resistivity? Already you know this. Okay. Means rho in the sense it defines what type of material it is. Different material will have different fixed value of resistivity at one particular temperature. Okay, purely resistivity depends upon the nature of the material. Resistivity does not depends upon the dimensions, Nana. Just it depends upon the nature of the material. And now because resistance depends upon rho, means it depends upon the nature of the material and it depends upon length and area of cross section of the wire also. Resistance depends upon length and area, and along with that it depends upon the rho value also. Okay, and here this rho can be written as R A by L. Rho, how to write? R A by L we can write. Resistivity can be written as R A by L. Students, now let us write SI unit. SI unit of resistivity is resistance. SI unit is, you know, ohm. Area SI unit is meter square upon length. SI unit is meter. Meter cancel. Yes, resistivity unit is ohm meter. Ohm into meter is the SI unit of resistivity. Hyphen it. Ohm into meter. The hyphen signs indicates it is ohm into meter. Okay. Define resistivity. What is resistivity? Resistivity means what? How to define? See, let us suppose, students, if length of the wire is 1 unit and area of cross section is also 1 unit, then rho will become R. Correct. Rho will become R. Means resistivity of a material of a wire is equal to resistance of the wire. Means opposition to the flow of the electrons when the length of the wire is 1 unit. And area of cross section of the wire is 1 unit. Okay, when you keep length of the wire and area of cross section of the wire is equal to 1 unit, then how much resistance, how much oppositions to the flow of current you will get, flow of electrons you will get, that oppositions we call it as resistivity. Resistivity value, it purely depends upon nature of the material only. It does not depends upon, resistivity does not depends upon the dimensions. It is a fixed value for a particular material at a constant temperature. You need to remember that. Okay, na? Clear? Yes. Students, this is ohm into meter. Ohm meter, we can say. Now, this reciprocal of resistivity, we call it as conductivity. What we call, na? Conductivity. Reciprocal, if you take 1 by resistivity, you will get conductivity. You need to remember this, conductivity. Okay, you remember like this, reciprocal of resistivity is nothing but conductivity. Yes, what is the SI unit of conductivity? SI unit of conductivity is see, 1 divided by ohm meter. Means nothing but ohm inverse, meter inverse. Okay, remember this. Conductivity, SI unit is ohm inverse, meter inverse, or 1 divided by ohm meter. Students, 1 by ohm or ohm inverse is also called as mho. What we call? MHO mho. See, ohm is OHM, ohm. This is ohm. Now, ohm inverse, it is nothing but OHM inverse. It is nothing but MHO. Just right reverse. Mho. What we call it is mho. We call it as mho. Okay. Means this one can be written as mho into MHO. Mho into meter inverse. Okay. And this mho is also called as, or ohm inverse is also called as Siemens. What we call? Siemens into meter inverse. You need to remember all these names. Anything they may ask you, what we call this? Siemens. Right, this is Siemens-meter-inverse. You have to remember this. Similarly, reciprocal of resistance is called as conductivity, conductance. What we call this is conductance. For resistance, if you take reciprocal of that value, you will get conductance. So conductance unit is SI unit of conductance. SI unit of conductance is, see, it is G, we will represent with G, and it is nothing but 1 by R. It is nothing but 1 by SI unit I am writing 1 by ohm. It is nothing but ohm inverse. You can write like this, or you can write Siemens. Ohm inverse is also called as Siemens. You need to remember these all units. Yes, Siemens is the SI unit of ohm inverse. It is also called as mho. Okay, just remember these names. This is all just for one more questions. Sometimes they may ask you in your board exam. Sometimes, yes, mho and Siemens. Mho, this is nothing but ohm inverse, this is nothing but mho, MHO mho. Is also called as, mho is also called as Siemens. Remember these all things. Okay, students? Yes. So, now, just now we have discussed that, friends, R is equal to rho L by A we have discussed.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Students, let us write this resistivity in another formula. Means resistivity I have written R A by L, no? Yes, let us write this one in different formula. See, students, as we know, what is that one? Yes. You take current density. What is current density? What is the relation between current and drift velocity, Nana? Yes, the relation is I is equal to NEA VD. Do you remember this? I is equal to NEA VD. Clear? Yeah. And we know that VD is nothing but E capital E by M into tau. Means you can write I is equal to NEA into E capital E by M into tau. Means we can write it as I is equal to N E square A by M tau into E. Students, as we know one formula, that relation between current, electric field and potential difference is E is equal to dV by dr. Negative sign. Negative sign indicates electric field is in the direction of potential difference. Okay. Now, let us suppose electric field is uniform. Then you can write E is equal to V by something distance. Distance I will write with L. Okay, na? Magnitude of electric field we can write for a uniform electric field. We can write E is equal to potential difference per unit length. Means here, let us suppose here wire is there having a length L. Okay. Now, across this wire, let us suppose one battery is connected like this. Here one electric field will generate in this direction. That electric field value will be E by L, you know. Already discussed. Okay, let us substitute that. When we know E is equal to V by L, do you know? Yes. Electric field can be written as potential difference per unit length. Okay. Now let us substitute this value here. What you will get? You will get I is equal to, students, observe carefully, N E square A tau by M into E value. E value can be written as V by L. Can we write? Yes, we can write. Okay. Okay, students, again this one we can rearrange like this. I is equal to N E square tau by M into A divided by L into V. Can we write? A divided by L I have written separately somewhat, and this total I have written. Clear? I have not changed anything here. Just I have rearranged this. A I have written here and V separately I have written. Okay, now this can be written as V is equal to something I into M into L by N E square tau by A. Can we write? Yes, V is equal to, this total should go this side, M divided by M into L divided by N E square tau by A. Can we write? Yes, we can write. Clear? Now, see, if you observe carefully, students, this total quantity, what is M here? Yes. Here M is nothing but mass of electron, a fixed value. Clear? N. What is N? Nana? N is number of electrons per unit volume, as we have discussed in earlier previous class. Small n indicates number of electrons per unit volume for one particular material. It will be a fixed value. What is E? Charge of electron, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb, a fixed value. Tau, relaxation time at one particular temperature. If you take relaxation time is nothing but shortest time interval between any two collisions of electron. It is also a fixed value. Let us suppose one particular wire we have taken, conducting wire. That wire will have fixed length and fixed area of cross section. Means this total thing is one constant value. Now if you compare this total equation with your known equation, that is V is equal to IR, then we can say that R will be equal to M into L divided by N E square tau by A. Can we say? Yes. Yes, it is nothing but resistance, Nana. Okay. And still, if you observe carefully, it can be written as R is equal to M divided by N E square tau L by A. Still, if you observe carefully this one, it is, we can write rho L by A. If you compare it with this one, you will get, yes, resistivity rho can be written as m divided by n e square tau. Yes, very, very, very important value. You must remember this and this. Okay. So now you see, I told you that resistivity of a material depends upon just nature of the material, which type of wire it is, either it is copper or aluminium or nichrome or something, any alloy, depends upon that material. Why, sir? See here, this formula, rho formula, if you observe, it is mass of the electron divided by number of electrons per unit volume in charge of electron and relaxation time. Here means for one fixed material or one fixed conducting material and one fixed temperature, this value will be constant. Means rho will be a constant for a fixed material at one particular temperature. Means it depends upon the nature of the material, what type of material. Different materials may have different values of n. However, m, mass of electron, charge of electron may be constant. But depending upon the nature of the material, see, you take silver, you may have different number of free electrons. Aluminium, you take different number of free electrons. Copper, you take different number of free electrons. Means number of free electrons depends upon nature of the material. Here number of free electrons term is there. Means this term depends upon nature of the material. So resistivity of a material depends upon nature of the material. Fix it. Okay, and the formula for resistivity, actual formula is m divided by n e square into tau. Only the thing is, see, for one particular material, m value we know, e value we know, relaxation time, let us suppose they have given. Now, by knowing the material nature, we can come to know how many number of free electrons will be present in particular material. Then we can calculate rho value easily. Clear? Okay, yes. So this is about a resistivity. Resistivity is nothing but m divided by n e square tau. So you may get this option among the following, which will be the resistivity of a material. Yes, this is the resistivity of a material. Okay, students, you may get different option also. Yes, see how, students, as you know, yeah, let us write this one in terms of current density. Students, you know, current density, I'll rub these all things, okay. Or otherwise, in terms of drift velocity, I'll write first. Students,
will not use this. Let us use another factor. That is, you know, current density J is equal to what? Nana? I by A, as you know. And you know, I is nothing but N E A V D. Divided by A. So J can be written as NEVD. Means this still it can be written as NE into what is VD? You know, VD value right here. VD is nothing but EE by M into tau. So let us write EE by M into tau. Yes. So current density J can be written as n e square tau by m into e. Yeah, students, see here, n e square tau divided by m. Yeah, let us take that one. Yeah, so I am taking n e square tau by m is equal to what, Nana? J divided by e. Correct. N e square tau by m is nothing but J by e. Okay, na? Yes. Now, but we have m by n e square by tau. So what you will get? M divided by n e square tau. Will you get E by J? So let us write here. Rho can be written as E divided by J. Both are vector quantities. Okay. Yeah. You can get this formula also sometimes in your objective questions. You need to remember this. Okay, na? Yes. Still, students, still this can be written as rho is equal to E divided by, yes, what is J? J is nothing but NEVD. NE
VD. Clear? Yes, here, from here I am writing. And you know one more formula, mobility, mu is nothing but VD by E. Do you know? Yes, this rho can be written as 1 divided by NE into VD by E. Can we write? Yes, E is a lid bound. Yours, we'll get rho is equal to 1 by NE into mu. Many formulas, you may get different formulas. Okay, na? So all these formulas you must remember. Mu is nothing but mobility. I said no, defined yesterday. In yesterday's class we have defined mu is nothing but mobility, drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. Mobility is that only I have written. Rho is equal to 1 by NE mu. Okay, still students, still this can be written. How we can write? Yes, see, I'll rub this one. Rho can be written as C. Yeah. So E divided by N E V D I have written. And we know E is nothing but V by L. So V by N E into L into V D. Can we write? What it? See here. V by L into V D. Okay, all the formulas you must remember, all formulas, mainly this formula you remember and this formula you remember, you will get all formulas, everything we should have practiced enough many times so that you can remember this all thing. However, after 10 days, 15 days, again 1 month, 2 months, you may forget, but if you remember the concept again, you can get back. Okay, na? The concepts, basic logic formulas you should remember, then everything will come. Okay, one more important derivation we will get for 5 marks, from here only I will explain you. Okay, now students, now we will explain, we will discuss on what factor resistivity depends. Factors is very important, factors which affects the resistivity. On what factors resistivity depends? Resistivity formula, what is it? Resistivity is nothing but M divided by N E square into tau. However, M and E are constant values. You know, these are constant values. Okay. Now, rho is can be written as proportional to 1 divided by N into tau. Here, N indicates nature of material. Nature of material means which type of material, different materials will have different resistivity. Means resistivity depends upon nature of the material. Next, second point is nothing but tau is nothing but relaxation time. Yes, students, what is relaxation time, Nana? Yes, relaxation time is nothing but the average time for which a free electron accelerates before two consecutive collisions. Means between two consecutive collisions. Means here, let us suppose conducting wire is there here, and now here electron is moving from here to again here with positive ion. Let us suppose it is collided. For how much time it will accelerate without any collision? That time is called as relaxation time. Now this relaxation time depends upon temperature, Nana. See, let us suppose if you increase the temperature of this capital T I am writing. If you increase the temperature of this conducting material, what happened? If you increase the temperature, the thermal energy gained by the electron will be more. So if they will gain more energy, more fast they will move. Okay, na? Because of more energy they get, they will speed up. When they will speed up, the time interval between these two collision will get reduced. Are you getting? Yes. So with increase in temperature, relaxation time decreases, but we know resistivity is inversely proportional to relaxation time. From here means resistivity for conductors I am talking about.
okay, resistivity increases. That implies resistivity increases.
Why you understood? No, resistivity of a material or conductor. What happened to that? What happened to the resistivity of a conductor with increase in temperature? With increase in temperature, relaxation time of electron between two collisions will decrease. Why it will decrease? Because with increase in temperature, thermal energy gained by the electron increases. When the energy increases, they will move with a large speed. Means the time interval between the collision will decrease. Due to that, due to this, resistivity will increase. So resistivity of a material depends upon two factors. One is nature of the material. Second one is temperature. Okay? Yeah. They may ask you one more question. How resistivity of a conductor depends upon temperature? Resistivity of a conductor increases with increase in temperature and decreases with decrease in temperature. If you decrease the temperature, relaxation time will increase. That means resistivity will decrease. I am talking about conductors, for conductors, pure conductors. Okay, na? Clear? Yes. So resistivity of a conductor depends upon nature of the material and temperature, and how it will vary with temperature also I have explained. Okay, students. Yes. Now let us discuss about resistance. Resistance is nothing but R is equal to rho L by A. So how resistance is changes, resistivity changes, resistance also same changes, same as it is. Means with increase in temperature, resistivity increases. That means resistance also increases with increase in, for conductors.
For conductors, temperature increases means relaxation time decreases. That implies resistivity increases. That implies resistance also increases. You need to remember this point. This is for conductors. Okay,
for semiconductors it will be different. We will discuss later, because you don't know, you are not having clear idea about semiconductors.